This is the second video about clippers using Zener diodes. If you haven't seen the previous video, please do watch that video before watching this. In the previous video, we have seen circuits using Zener diode. We have seen these two circuits in the previous video, where the first circuit was giving us the positive half of the wave and working on it with the reference VZ. Anything above it was being clipped. And of course, it was not allowing even the negative half of the wave, by the way. And coming to the second circuit, which was giving us only the negative half of the wave, and that too, it was working on that negative half of the wave and clipping a portion less than minus VZ, the breakdown voltage of that diode. Now, in this video, we're going to see a combination of both of it in one circuit, and that circuit is like this. So let me say this is circuit number 3. So in this case, let me say both the Zener diodes are different so that we would understand this operation in a more detail. And let me take some numericals here that the breakdown voltage of diode 1 is 6 volts. And the breakdown voltage of the second Zener diode is 8 volts. So let's analyze this. So first case, we know that D1 and D2, D1 is going to work on the positive half of the wave and D2 is going to work on the negative half of the wave. So we'll start with saying VI is greater than 0. When VI is greater than 0, obviously D2 is going to be in forward bias and short circuit. So we have to worry only about the D1 now, because D2 is going to be forward bias, hence short circuit. But D1 will be reverse bias. It acts like open circuit. If the input voltage is in between 0 and the breakdown voltage, let me be specific, VZ1. In that case, when D1 is open circuit, in that case, the output voltage will be equal to the input voltage under this condition. Now, in the same scenario, D1 can get to breakdown, so that we have to take it like a voltage source with VZ1 if VI is greater than VZ1. And throughout this, we are satisfying that VI is greater than 0. So even in VI is greater than 0, there are two conditions. That is VI in between 0 and VZ1. The other one, VI is greater than VZ1, in which case diode 1, the Zener diode 1, enters into breakdown. In that case, V0 will be equal to VZ1. Now let's get to the second case where VI is less than 0. Obviously, when VI is less than 0, D1 will be forward biased, so we can take that to be short circuit. Now we have only D2 to be worried about. So when it comes to D2, obviously it will be in reverse bias. Of course, it will be in reverse bias, not in breakdown region, given the condition that given VI is less than 0 and greater than minus VZ2. Ensuring that Zener diode 2 is not in breakdown region. In that case, it will be like an open circuit. Hence, the output voltage will be equal to input voltage under this condition that input voltage is in between this range. But if the input voltage becomes less than minus VZ2, so D2 will enter into breakdown region, where we have to model this with a voltage like this. In which case, this is possible if VI is less than minus VZ2. In which case, V0 will be equal to minus VZ2 under this condition of input. So now, having all the conditions, one thing to remember that we took VZ1 is equal to 6 volts and VZ2 is equal to 8 volts. So we have conditions taken here that when VI is positive, D1 is in action because it is in reverse bias. So in that, it is divided into two segments where VI is in between 0 and VZ1. So VZ1 is 6. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So that point is here. So this is 6 volts, which is corresponding to VZ1. So in this region, D1 is acting on the input, where D2 is simply short circuit, as it is forward biased. D1 is in reverse bias, or it gets into breakdown. Now when VI is in between 0 and VZ1, V0 is equal to VI. So it will be a 45 degree line meeting this point. So as for this segment, V0 is equal to VI, which is shown here. When VI is greater than VZ1, which is this segment, V0 is equal to VZ1. So this is VZ1, which we have said is 6 volts. This is also 6 volts. So V0 is going to be simply 6 volts. Now coming to the negative side of VI, where D1 was on, which means it was short circuit, and D2 was in action in reverse bias or in breakdown region depending on the voltage, and VZ2 we have seen was 8 volts, which means in this case it will show as minus 8 volts, as we have seen here. So minus 8 reference is here, and for V0 minus 8 is here. This is 8 volts, this is minus VZ2. Now in this case, if you see that when VI is in between 0 and minus 8 volts, V0 is equal to VI, which means it's going to be a 45 degree line extension in the fourth quadrant. Coming to the last condition, where VI is less than minus VZ2, which means it is in this side, where output voltage is equal to minus VZ2, which is minus 8 volts. So we'll have characteristics like this. So if you want to show it with respect to a sinusoid waveform, let's just take, we have an input sinusoid wave like this, where the peak value is plus 10 volts, and then here minus 10 volts. If we take this waveform through this clipper, we're going to get an output waveform clipped in the positive side at 6 volts, and on the negative side it will be clipped at minus 8 volts. So we'll have a waveform at the output like this. So here the peak value will be 6 volts, and here it will be minus 8 volts. But a note here that we haven't considered the forward bias cut-in voltage for the Zener diode here. So you can take that as an exercise and try it out yourself. But the conclusion is, if we take cut-in voltages, if Zener diodes cut-in voltages are considered, which is let's say 0.7 volts, then the clipping levels will be 6.7 volts and minus 8.7 volts. If you like this video, please give a thumbs up. If you haven't subscribed yet, please do subscribe, and thank you for watching.